you didn't knock.
Habit. Oh, my God. Well, this place doesn't even look like my office anymore.
Thank you. Wasn't easy.
How could you do this? I mean, you took away all the charm, all the warmth. Where's Dave?
Dave?
My moosehead.
I set him free. If he really loves you, he'll come back. Here you go.
What's it?
A severance check. Please be a stranger.
Why? What'd I do?
In baseball ease, Mr. Malone, you showed me up. You and the rest of the Cats and Jammer kids. Goodbye.
Now, wait a minute. What about that conversation you had with your,
My what?
Your heart. Your heart. You pitied me.
You've spent your pity, Mr. Malone.
Okay, fine. Yeah, you know, I don't want your pity anyway. You know, I can live without this job. I'll find another way of supporting myself. And my mother. I mean, now the doctor's only given me 6 months to live. Come on, please, listen. I swear to you, nothing like this will ever happen again. Come on, a decent boss would give me a second chance. I'll tell you something,
Don't say a guy would.
I wasn't going to say a guy would. But he would.
All right. I'll give you another chance.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.
But I want to make something very clear.
Okay.
You've just got one chance left. Mm-hmm. And as far as I'm concerned, again in baseball ease, it's the bottom of the ninth. You've got two outs, two strikes, and no ball.
Yeah.
I want this nonsense with my picture to stop. I did you a favor by hiring you back, and this is not a very nice way to repay me.
You're right. You did do me a favor, and now I'm going to do you one. I'm going to give you a tip on how to deal with people who work for you. Lighten up a little bit. I mean, you got to make some compromises.
I see. You want me to hang your picture back out?
Right.
Done.
Whoa, that was easy. Wait, let's try some more compromises here. I want to sleep with you 25 times, but you don't want to sleep with me at all, am I right?
Right.
Okay, so what's half of 25?
Your IQ. It's all right. It happens to everybody.
He made up this whole story just to avoid committing to me. And the worst part is, he's going to get away with it. They always do.
Yeah, men are such a pain. I have someone who's very special to me, but he wouldn't notice me if I set fire to my hair.
Him?
No, definitely not him. I prefer the Fortune 500 type. One who owns blocks, not one who plays with them.
Let me talk to you a minute. Miss Howe, I think I can get this wedding back on track.
Thank God.
Yeah, but I have one little condition.
You pull this off and you can have anything you want.
Really?
Except that.
Actually, all I want to do is get rid of these stupid uniforms.
Mr. Malone, ever since you have worked here, you have done nothing but whine about these uniforms. Now, I put a great deal of thought into them, and I happen to think they make a statement.
Oh, yeah, they say I'm a lima bean. All right, fine. You insist on keeping these uniforms, then there'll be no wedding, no wedding reception, and you and Mr. Drake can spend an intimate evening watching 40 quarts of guacamole turn black.
Fine. Get rid of the uniforms.
Okay. Woody. Get on the phone. Tell the church we're running a little bit late. Cliff, see if you can catch up with Eddie there.
You bet.
Norm, stay in the office. Make sure Carla does not trash it. Yes, you.
Frazier.
Go pick up Carla's gown, will you?
Right. Oh, say, if anybody needs me, just tell them I'm at the Gownorama, Trala.
That was all well and good.
Thank you.
How do you plan on getting the bride and groom back together?
I'm going to rely on my wits.
Well, you're halfway there.
You better believe it.
Here's a happy pair. Say cheeseburger. No. All right, that was a good one. Even with Miss Al's eyes kind of gimpy like that.
Oh, no, we forgot about the dessert table.
And we call ourselves guests.
Ma, do you want to trade partners?
Why not? I'm going to die.
I'm going to dance with my mother. All right?
How about a cup of coffee, huh?
Why would I do that?
Well, because I've seen a lot of ladies hit the champagne in my time. One minute they're doing just fine, the next minute kind of sneaks up on them, and they're doing all sorts of wild and crazy. Why am I giving you coffee?
So, Eddie, what's Mother Tortelli like in bed?
What are you looking at, pretty lady?
I'm looking at you.
Well, I'm looking back at you.
I think I'm beginning to see you in a whole new light.
Well, why don't you tell me what you see?
You have a really weird face. Your eyebrows are growing together like a big, old, ugly caterpillar. Oh, look. They're cutting the cake.